Danger lurks in the big city. Disaster waits in every dark alley. Peril behind every park bench. The world needs a hero! But not just an ordinary hero, no! A special hero! A superhero! I am that hero! They call me Larry Boy! Wherever there is trouble, I'll be there! Whatever a helpless vegetable calls out, I will answer! Evildoers, beware! You are no match for the awesome power of Larry Boy and his super suction ears! You doubt? A demonstration!
Hi, kids. I'm Bob the Tomato, and I think that's Larry the Cucumber.
I'm Larry Boy. Who are you?
Larry, it's me, Bob.
Bob? Bob, I know no Bob. Say there, citizen. Would you give me a hand with my super suction ear? It seems to have malfunctioned.
Okay. What do I do?
Well, it's just that I'm afraid it's about to let... go. Ouch.
Wow. I didn't know being a superhero could be so painful. Maybe you should just go back to being plain old Larry.
But I don't want to be plain old Larry anymore.
Why not?
Well, there's nothing special about plain old Larry. He can't do anything neat like fly or save people or anything. He's just plain old boring.
Oh, not feeling very special, huh?
Nope.
Hmm. Hey, I know.
What?
I could... Larry, my no...
Sorry.
You got my...
Face, Bob. Bob, pull back. Pull back, Bob.
Well, what I was going to say is that we... Ow! That's smart.
Hey, look. I'm a Larry-go-round.
As I was saying, we just got a letter from Myra Eggleston of Youngstown, Pennsylvania. Now, Myra has a lot of brothers and sisters, and they're all bigger than she is. She says that they can do really neat things like play soccer and dance ballet, but Myra's too little. So Myra wants to know what's special about her.
Oh, Myra, I know how you feel.
Well, Myra and Larry... I'm going to tell you a story about a boy named Dave. Now, Dave lived in a land called Israel a long, long time ago. So long ago that there weren't any cars or telephones or vacuum cleaners or anything. There were mostly just sheep, especially around Dave's house, because Dave was a shepherd. No, that's not him. That's one of his brothers. Nope, another brother. Another brother. Dave had a lot of brothers. Aha, there he is. No, not the sheep. He's behind the sheep. Shoo there, Fluffy.
Hi, I'm Dave. I have a lot of brothers.
Yep, 7 to be exact. Now, Dave and his brothers spent most of their time in the fields taking care of their sheep, which could be hard work because their sheep had an unusual problem.
They tip over. Oh, look, there goes one now.
But Dave had an even bigger problem. You see, of all the brothers, he was the smallest.
That's right. Everybody's bigger than I am.
And sometimes his big brothers would pick on him.
Oh, Dave, one of my sheep fell over. Would you come pick it up for me?
I'm kind of busy right now.
Do you remember the time we dipped you in tar and stuck you to the backside of an angry water buffalo?
I'll be right there.
Hey, Dave, one of my sheep fell too.
Just a minute.
Oh, look. All of my sheep fell over. Dave.
Oh, Dave, after you pick up our sheep, could you run and get me a bite to eat? I'm famished.
Oh, yeah, me too. Get me something, too.
You know, sometimes I think I could eat a whole camel.
Oh, yeah? Well, sometimes I think I could eat a whole spaceship.
What's a spaceship?
I have no idea.
That's how things had pretty much always been for Dave. Nothing really exciting happened around there until one day when their dad, Jesse, came running out with some horrible news.
Whoa! Dave, can you pick those up? Oh, boys! I got horrible news! The Philistines are attacking!
The lima beans are, lacking?
The nectarines are quacking?
One more time, please, and let's work on our enunciation.
The Philistines are attacking!
Bob, what are the Philippines?
The Philippines are a group of islands off the coast of Southeast Asia, but that's not important now. The Philistines were people who hated Israel. They wanted to take Israel's land and make the Israelites their slaves, so they'd have to do whatever the Philistines told them to do.
Oh, that's bad.
You're right. So the Israelites needed to protect themselves.
We need to protect ourselves, but how?
King Saul is putting together an army to stop the Philistines. He needs your help. You must help save Israel.
We must help save Israel.
Hey, Dave, where do you think you're going?
I must help save Israel.
It's very nice that you want to help, but saving a country is a big thing. You're a little guy. Big people do big things, and little people do little things. So, stay with the sheep.
They're big. I'm little. They go. I twiddle. Why can't little guys do big things too?
By the time Dave's brothers arrived at King Saul's camp, battle lines had been drawn between the Philistines and the Israelites. And, as was the custom in their day, the armies lined up and yelled at each other.
Hello, Israelites! Soon we will put apples in your mouths and stick you in our toaster ovens!
Oh, yes, after we defeat you, you will be our slaves and you will have to fetch us our slippers!
Yes, and iron our trousers!
Oh, and wipe our little noses!
Aha! And scratch that spot on our backs we cannot reach no matter how hard we try! Don't you have anything to say? Do you guys have any fried chicken? I've got a real hankering for fried chicken.
Yeah, me too.
This is going to be easier than we thought. You know, I think I can save us all a lot of time. How about if we bring out our strongest man, and you bring out your strongest man, and they will fight. If our champion beats your champion, you will be our slaves. But if your champion defeats us, we will be your slaves. What do you think about that?
Well, the Israelites were getting kind of tired of the yelling, and the Philistines did seem a little on the small side, so King Saul agreed.
That seems like a reasonable idea. All right, we agree. Send out your champion.
Hey, Goliath!
Who will I fight?
The Israelites were so terrified of Goliath that they all ran away and hid.
Nobody will fight. I'll come back tomorrow.
And that's exactly what he did. Goliath came back the next day, and the next day, and the next day for 40 days. But every time he showed up, all the Israelites ran away and hid. Finally, Jesse started to worry about his boys, so he sent little Dave to the battlefield with some food. Now, Dave got to King Saul's camp just about the time Goliath was going to come out, so all the Israelites were hiding.
Hello? Is anybody here?
Shh, he'll hear you.
Who?
Him, that big pickle over there.
Who will fight me?
Well, who's gonna fight him?
What, are you nuts? He'd have us for lunch. Speaking of which, what'd you bring us?
Here you go.
Mmm, pizza.
Oh, cheese in the crust. That's tremendous.
Come on, guys.
Oh, no one to fight. They told me that you are the children of God. You are cowards. I come back tomorrow.
I can't believe you're letting him say that. Somebody's gotta do something.
What are you gonna do, Dave? Remember, you're a little guy. Leave this big stuff to us big people. Do you think he saw me?
No, you're okay.
Phew.
Well, Dave knew exactly what he had to do, so he went straight to King Saul and announced his plan.
I will fight Goliath!
King Saul took the news rather well.
I'm sorry, my ears must be failing. I could have sworn I heard you say that you'd fight Goliath. But you didn't say that, did you?
Yes, I did!
Oh, I say, that's very kind, but let's be reasonable. You are a tiny little fellow, and, well, Goliath, he's enormous. No, 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 that's a job for a big person, not a little boy like you. You're not going to sing, are you? Couldn't you just play your harp and I'll throw things at you? Oh.
You're big, I'm little. My head only comes to your middle. But I say little guys can do big things too.
Oh, I see what you're saying. All right, I understand. Now, let's suppose that this is true. You still look rather wimpy, but I know what we can do. Just step behind this curtain. It will only take a minute. There's a closet in the corner, and you'll like what I've got in it. You'll find my royal armor there. Now, Danny, put it on. Yes, now you'll look much bigger when the battle lines are drawn. One more thing you'll need, I think. Pick up my royal sword. It's a big one and a beauty. The best we could afford. Once you've got it all together, I think you will agree. You're bound to do much better if you try to look like me.
Oh, dear.
You know, I think maybe I should just be plain old me.
Oh, yes. Well, I suppose. But have you seen Goliath?
Well, Dave wasn't exactly sure what he was getting into, so he went down to a stream and found 5 smooth stones. Then he went back to the camp and waited for Goliath.
Who will fight me?
I will fight you, Goliath!
You know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that sounded like Dave.
Oh, yeah. You know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that looks like Dave.
Huh? Dave?
Goliath was equally surprised.
Who said that?
I did!
Huh? Whoa, am I a dog that you come at me with sticks?
I don't exactly know what you mean.
We will see who defeats who. Now we fight.
It's showtime!
Ha ha ha!
The Philistines were so scared of Dave that they all ran away and hid, and Israel was saved. And that's the story of Dave, a really little guy who did a really big thing. Well, what did you think of the story?
Oh, my goodness. That was amazing. Dave was just a teeny little guy, but he beat Goliath, who was the biggest, strongest guy they'd ever seen. Oh, my. I laughed. I cried. It moved me, Bob.
Well, good. Now, in our story, no one thought David could do anything important. After all, he was just a little guy. Why, even King Saul tried to change David by putting his own armor on him. It kind of reminds me of another guy who thought he had to put on a costume to be special.
Yeah. He took on that old Goliath when all the other guys were too scared to try.
But that's not all, Larry. David went on to be the king of all Israel.
Wow. That's pretty good for a little guy.
Well, that's pretty good for any guy.
Yeah. Then I sure don't need to dress up like a superhero to be special.
Nope. Larry, you're special just the way you are.
Aw, thanks, Bob. The hero. I am that hero. They call me Larry Boy. Bob? Bob? Could you give me a hand? Hey there, citizen. Hey, you're over there.
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Laddie, the part of the show where Laddie comes out and sings a silly song. One day, while talking with Dr. Archibald, Laddie confronts one of his deepest fears.
If my lips ever left my mouth, packed a bag and headed south, that'd be too bad. I'd be so sad.
I see, that'd be too bad. You'd be so sad.
That'd be too bad.
All righty.
If my lips said adios, I don't like you, I think you're gross, that'd be too bad. I might get mad.
That'd be too bad. You might get mad.
That'd be too bad.
Fascinating.
If my lips moved toodaloof, left a mess and took my tooth, that'd be too bad. I'd call my dad.
Oh dear, that'd be too bad. You'd call your dad.
That'd be too bad.
Hold it. Did you say your father? Fascinating! So what you're saying is, if your lips left you...
That'd be too bad, I'd be so sad, I might get mad, I'd call my dad, that'd be too bad.
That'd be too bad.
That'd be too bad.
Why?
'Cause I love my lips. Bee-dee-bap-bop-bee-dee-bop-boo, ee-ba-da-bop-boo-ba-da-boo-bow. Yabba-dab-bop-dee-ba-bop-boom-bom-bee-dee-bop-bop-dow. Yabba-dab-a-dab-a-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-bee-dee-bop-
Oh, my. This is more serious than I thought. Laddie, what do you see here?
That looks like a lip.
What about this?
It's a lip.
And this?
It's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 it's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 it's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 lip.
Laddie, tell me about your childhood.
When I was just 2 years old, I left my lips out in the cold and they turned blue. What could I do?
Oh, dear. They turned blue. What could you do?
Oh, they turned blue.
I see.
On the day I got my tooth, I had to kiss my great Aunt Ruth. She had a beard, and it felt weird.
My, she had a beard, and it felt weird?
She had a beard.
Oh.
10 days after I turned 8, got my lips stuck in a gate. My friends all laughed, and I just stood there until the fire department came and broke the lock with the crowbar, and I had to spend the next 6 weeks in lip rehab with this kid named Oscar who got stung by a bee right on the lip, and we couldn't even talk to each other until the 5th week because both of our lips were so swollen, and when he did start speaking, he just spoke Polish, and I only knew like 3 words in Polish, except now I know 4 because Oscar taught me the word for lip. Usta.
Your friends all laughed. Usta. How do you spell that?
I don't know.
So what you're saying is that when you were young...
They turned blue, what could I do? She had a beard and it felt weird. My friends all laughed. What the?
I'm confused.
I love my lips.
This has been Silly Songs with Laddie. Tune in next time to hear Laddie say...
Have I ever told you how I feel about my nose?
Look at the time!
Bye, ba boop, ba bee, ba bee, ba boop, ba.